about to get ugly. Welcome to the 2020-2021 hunting video, Hunting with Cash. We are kicking this video off in Arkansas. This will be the opening day of teal season. It's going to be one of the first hunts with my young dog, June. She's about a year and a half old. She's been on a few hunts, just me and her and Becca filming, but this will be one of the first ones she's had with multiple guns and also with blind retrieves. So we'll see how this goes.
All right, let's kill them on three. One, two, three. June!
I was watching this video back while Becca was editing it. I noticed a few things I wanted to put out right here. June is about a year and a half old. She hunted a few times last season. And she's probably about a season level dog as far as training goes. But she's still a young dog and she's still very inexperienced in hunting situations. So while we're out here having fun, we still need to put the dog first and remember that we're experiencing decoys, we're experiencing blind retrieves, different fields, different terrains, and we need to make sure we're still building the dog at this point and we're not pushing them too hard past where their training level is.
Check it off. catch me riding dirty. Trying to catch me riding dirty. Trying to catch me riding dirty. Trying to catch me riding dirty.
I can't wait for you to see this pontoon blind we built. We're going to hunt out of it this weekend on opening day. if it's still there and hasn't sunk. About taking shots like that. Kill him.
Check it out.
kill him.
We got three.
Chief!
Two over there, Reese.
Two more that fell.
Huh? We got four, you know.
I think that's two of me.
I think
you. Kill it.
Good boy. shoot him on the way down.
Chief, atta boy, bring me my band.
Check it out, atta boy.
Want some red feet on that one. Red legs, number three. I should have shot that pass before.
Thank you. dog pick up a goose like that. I'm used to seeing a big lab out there.
Bayou Bottoms Outfitters and Guide Service in around Jonesboro, Arkansas. It's New Year's Day, January the 1st, 2021. Got rid of 2020 pretty good fast.
Yep.
We shot us a 4-man limit of specs this morning, and basically over a dry field with sheet water. And we're going to do a little segment with Ben here. He is a spec calling machine. And tell us a little bit about calling specs.
All right. The main thing with them is just, specs, and part of the reason why I like hunting them so much is they're so vocal. You can talk back and forth to them and really hear them answering you when you blow the call. It's not like duck hunting where you don't get much response from ducks, or snow geese, you use a e-caller. But the thing I like about specs is just being able to talk to them and speak their language. But as the season goes on, you kind of have to really listen to them and tone it down. They've been hunted since the early October. So just listening to them and mimicking them's the big thing, the main thing. So
give us a little tutorial right there, kind of when finishing them off. How you finish them off?
Yeah, today we started out, we were kind of able to get away with a little bit more calling, but as the morning went on, or the day went on, I should say, we had to kind of tone it down and get a little bit quieter. So I just do single clucks and kind of mixing some murmurs with that. It just sounds something like this. So, and normally that works out pretty well. It did this morning. So.
Yeah, we had a good hunt. I appreciate it, man.
Absolutely. Thank you, guys.
Enjoyed it.
Shoot him, you red.
Good girl, good girl.
Shoot!
Headshot it too. He didn't just. That was a headshot.
Heel.
Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Here. Sit. Sit. Take it off. Take it off. Take it off. Good girl. Good girl. Good. Good girl. Good girl, good. Good, good girl, okay. Okay, good girl. Arkansas duck season, the best way to put it, has been terrible. And I mean, we ain't fired a gun in like 10 days, have we, Andrew?
No, so I've been in bed.
We're packing up. We're heading to western Oklahoma to hunt with Flatline Outfitters, shoot a bunch of little geese. They said they're loaded up with geese and ducks, so we'll see what we got. What do you think, Andrew?
We're going to go kill some stuff.
Okay!
Okay!
Okay! Hey, Andrew.
Yeah.
What are we going to do when we get out here in Oklahoma and we got like 10,000 of them little crackling geese over the top of us? How are we going to call the shot?
Kill them, you rednecks! Woo!
Bro tad.
I remember waiting on the school bus. Andrew Holman was my first crush. And neither
get ready. Here comes the cotton tops.
Just try to put side your way.
Yeah.
You got another one.
Chief!
These are the ones you want to get mine.
Good.
Just past the decoy.
Just past the decoy.
Here. Get in. Twice. Got another one. Dead bird.
That a boy, good. That a boy.
Toss it here.
Thing to always keep in mind, with a dog of any age, but especially a young dog, is when you get into some of these big goose spreads, whether it be full bodies or socks, different terrains, it's always a good thing to get out there and walk your dog through that. Let them see all the decoys, let them see the spinning wing decoys, and all the different setups that you're going to do, and it'll cut down on a lot of confusion and a lot of issues you may have throughout the hunt.
Tomahawk Kennels, baby. Get you some.
One-year-old dog.
Woo!
Honky!
Just two out there.
bird.
Hey, right here, snow. Let's snow.
Y'all get ready. Get ready. Get ready.
Dude, this bird's banded. Good girl, good. Good girl, good. That a girl, good. That a girl, shake it off, good.
Feet way across the field.
Yeah.
Way down there.
Duck Blind Bistro. Good for cinnamon rolls, warming up pizza, hot biscuits, eggs, bacon, sausage, pretty much anything you can think of. This is the key. This is the ticket right here. Give me those cinnamon rolls. Yoppin' biscuits. Like your grandma made. Whop. Anybody watching this is wondering, goose blood and rust are healthy for the human body.
Well, that's you of an act.
I need about 3 or 4 minutes on each side. Thing seals off, it smashes down, basically creates a Dutch oven effect. Good, really good for fat boys. They like them. All right. Ooh, yeah.
salmon rolls cooked to perfection. Looking for the best part.
Is that grass on it?
No. A little grass is good for you. You gotta have a little bit of green on your plate. Since you're growing up, your grandma probably cooked cinnamon rolls for you. And they was probably wonderful. But your grandma ain't got nothing on duck blind cinnamon rolls at all. No disrespect, grandma, but these babies here are good. So what you want to do is you glob it on there and let it melt a little. And that way you can stir it around and get everybody distributed equally. Of course, if you don't like somebody in the pit, you can always not give them quite as much. We're not sure if we like Brienne yet or not, so if anybody gets shorted, it'll be Cooking with Cash. Y'all stay tuned for more recipes. And the best part, after you get everybody washed down and icing real good, there's no possible way to get it all off. See, that's good. Hallelujah. Look at all that icing. Thank y'all for watching Johnny Cash Outdoors. Johnny Cash is duck blind kitchen. If you are the duck blind gourmet, like Cooking with Cash, you always get the middle cinnamon roll because it's good.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. That's it out. Let's go. Atta girl. Good. Hey, atta girl. Atta girl. Good. Atta girl. Atta girl. Good. Up, 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 up. Let's go. Atta girl. Atta girl. Good. Atta girl. Good. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Bring me that Pintail. Atta girl. Good girl. Drop. Good girl. Good. Good girl. Okay. Okay. Good girl. Cali's first retrieve. Big Pintail sprig. Good girl, good. Good girl, Cali.
Alright, so today I want to talk about your pup's first retrieve. So all summer long, maybe all last season, either you or your trainer has worked really hard getting your pup ready for their first hunt, their first season, and there's always a lot of questions about, you know, what do I do? This is new to me, just as new as it is to the dog. How do I handle this first hunt? So what I want to talk to you today about is, you know, I want to use the word intimate, and I want to use that because it's such a bonding experience. That first retrieve, that first season, the very first hunt together needs to be all about you and your dog. It doesn't need to be about you and 10 of your buddies, you know, having big rain outs and all that. It needs to be a very intimate setting. So this afternoon, it's very warm. It's an afternoon hunt. It's just me and my wife here. She's not shooting. She's filming. And we got Cali, and it's her first hunt. It's her very first retrieve. So we had a pair of Pintails come in. They worked the pit, and I could see that she's sitting right here under her little hut that I've got made for her. And I could see the birds working the whole time. So they come in and they're right in the kill hole, and it's an easy 20-yard shot. and I don't shoot both of them. I just shoot the drake, and the whole time she watches the drake fall, and I've got my eye on her. She doesn't break. She's not making any noise. She's not moving. She sees the bird fall. Cali, she goes and gets it. She goes out there. She marks the bird good. And what happens? It's a new bird to her. She's never smelled a pintail before. She's never smelled a freshly killed bird before. So she sniffs it. At that point, you don't want to get mad at your dog and try to rush your dog, try to shock your dog, try to, you know, do something to the dog. That you want the dog to have a good experience. So give the dog a few minutes. Cali, finally, I encouraged her. Good girl, fetch it up, let's go. She brings the bird back. That's the perfect setup for the dog's first retrieve. Say she would have came back without the bird. Well, that's not a time to use force. That's a time to go out there, pick the bird up, get the dog excited, get her to make a few retrieves, get your buddy or whoever you're hunting with to maybe go out there and throw it, reenact the situation, get her to retrieve it a few times. Now you've got a happy dog that understands what's going on, and you don't have to worry about fixing issues that you created that were unnecessary. So on that dog's first hunt, try to be just you and the dog. Try not, if you have somebody else to shoot, that's even better. Don't even shoot, just work the dog. We don't want to encourage any breaking. We want the dog to sit still. We want the dog to be able to see good. We want the dog to be comfortable. And that first hunt, the first few hunts, that first season, make it about you and your dog. You're going to have this dog for hopefully 10, 15 years, and this dog's going to be your number one retrieving buddy, your hunting partner. So take a little time, make sure you do it correctly, and you'll have a great dog for the rest of your life.
Shoot!
I can't believe you did that one. What the heck?
Shoot!
We might have got more of this stuff right here.
On the board.
Good girl, good girl. Good girl.
January 24th, Northeast Arkansas, 2021 season. We just killed two spoony hens. I couldn't be more happy in my life. This season has sucked, but we got them.
Bird.
Shoot!
Atta girl. Atta girl. Atta girl.
Good girl. Yeah. Got another one.
Yeah.
Where's your bird?
Atta girl.
Good girl.
Here. Drop it. Good girl. Oh yeah!
Drop it.
Another shovel.
Oh yeah.
When there's no wind, these socks, you don't really want to use any socks, just the silhouettes, you know. If there's no wind, you're fighting a losing battle anyways a lot of times, especially this year, stale birds and just the conditions we got. But in the morning, just have like a 15 mile an hour wind, gust up to 20 or 25 out of the north, so we're mixing a few socks in with our silhouette spread, and then we're going to set a snow spread up kind of off to the side. And so, you know, with that much wind, we're gonna get a lot of motion, and hopefully it'll be a good hunt. Putting out these snows, baby. Dive bomb snows. A lot of work. Pick them up, put them out. Pick them back up again, put them back out again. Chasing geese. Whew, gotta love it. Gotta love it. Awesome.
Okay.
Johnny Cash outdoors.
Thank you.
fog, no fog, it don't matter. It's about to go down.
Kill him!
Killed one.
We got a ring. We got the bull.
Running on her. You see it?
Yeah.
She don't see it.
Yeah. Yeah, he can shoot him over the ranger. He literally dropped one about 80 yards. I was impressed. This is gonna be like an epic hunt. Girl, big old bull.
Oh,
big old sprig on it.
Yeah.
shoot them, you rednecks.
The elusive green-headed mallard. He killed many this year.
Kill him.
Get in, hurry. Right over your head. What?
Out with the band, let me see.
Number two on the year. Juvenile.
June!
Yeah. Show the specs in the hole down there.
Yeah, I got you.
I'm gonna
set it. Burn them up.
Yeah, we're sitting out here. We've got a goose spread set up. We killed a limit of specks, and we've killed our second speck band of the year. Three lucky shooters. We're gonna draw. There's a feather in one of the shells, and then whoever gets it, if I don't get it, I'm gonna pay for the head. So one way or another, it's my band. We're just gonna, this run, this is just about the monetary value.
You wanna go first or last?
Go ahead.
I was going to
Can we get $5? Can I get $5? $10?
What is your amount?
I don't know.
$1,100.
Damn, now I really wish I would have shot that thing. $1,100?
How much you want for?
I don't know.
You're killing the spec band.
I'm giving 10, that's why I was here.
And the winner.
That's a wrap. 2020-2021. Number two for the year. Man, after this year, we went from bluebird days to two bird days.
Bluebird to full stripe next year.
I hear you, buddy. Boom.
Shoot them, you rednecks!
Okay!
Overall, the 2020-2021 season was a pretty rough year. We never got much rain. We just never got a migration for whatever reason. There's all kind of theories, but for whatever reason, it just didn't happen. But we had a lot of funny bloopers happen along the way. We started off opening day. Chad's new wheels on his trailer broke the studs out of the hubs. And right there on the rock and roll highway, we had to stop traffic and direct one-way traffic while we got that fixed and limped it on home. Not long after that, we had a ranger slide off in the bar ditch over at Honey Pond. Lucky that day, we had a good buddy, Andrew, and he came to the rescue and really brought us through. There's never a dull moment around Andrew. As long as he's around, he's the center of entertainment and always made sure everyone was having a good time. Sure do love my little buddy.
Hashtag DTMF.
Is this a video?
Oh!
put it to the right.
Okay. Hey, Andrew.
Yeah.
What are we going to do when we get out here in Oklahoma and we got like 10,000 of them little crackling geese over the top of us? How are we going to call the shot?
Kill them, you redneck! Woo!
Rotad. That would be so reserved. Hold it in.
No! No.
What is this?
Andrew.
Yeah.
Shoot him, you redneck!
I got it working. I had it on off.
I'm good. I'm good.
Just give it off. It'll burn all them gray hairs off. You might actually look 25 if you get lucky.
We got a 4-pack of cripples, five.
Here. Put that in there,
custom made just for you.
13th birthday ever. I hope puberty has not been too hard.
Man, we
that good.